Kind of the grind of conference play. Really proud of the way our team played against USD on a tough field and a cool night on Thursday. And then we headed to Fargo to play NDSU, and didn't play our best, but I think NDSU had a little bit to do with that, with how they played and how hard they played. And now we kind of find ourselves in a place where it's about how we respond to Sunday. So that's kind of the focus now.
Maggie, recap last Thursday and playing against USD. Obviously tough conditions, as Brock said. What was the key to get the victory there?
Just Brock says it all the time, being the most mentally tough team. And I think we definitely came out with that, and we got the series showdown point, and it was great to beat our in-state rival.
15 games, 8 shutouts, really, you know, defense has been the key of this team. How much do you credit the players in front of you? And obviously you got to talk about some of the saves you've made this year too, though.
I think all the credit goes to the people in front of me. I mean, if you look at the D-line, the mids, and the forwards, the ball's up there about the whole game. And if you look at the saves that I had, I think I had one save against USD, and we had possession 70% of the time. And, the shutout, it says I get the shutout, but I think, like, it's theirs. I'm just the one who gets the title, but, like, the way that the D plays, like, they've really outdone themselves this year. Like, this is their best year. It's really fun to watch.
How tough was it to go up to Fargo and, you know, have that result after what happened up there last year?
I think that we could have came out harder, and I think NDSU optimized on the opportunities that they got a little bit more. Losing is always hard, especially when it's a rival like that, but I think we're looking towards the next game and the next couple games to bounce back.
I was just going to ask, does that motivate the team to, you know, play your best these final three games, you know, because everything's on the line?
I think so. I think that after the result of the NDSU game, I think that kind of like motivates us and like puts a little bit more fire in us to want to prove like the kind of team we are. And I think we have perfect conditions this week in training, and the senior game this weekend, and playing UNO at home and having two home games. I think it's a perfect environment for us to show everyone what kind of team we are.
What is it about playing at Fishback? I don't think in conference play you guys have allowed a goal there in quite some time now.
I think a lot of it has to do with the fan base and how big the community supports us, and how many people we get to come out to our games. I think just playing in that kind of environment, and knowing like you have so many fans and like hearing everybody, and just the kind of the feel of it, I guess, like that's the only way I can put it, the feel on game day at Fishback. It really just like makes it feel like it's game day. So yeah.
Brock, a little bit for the dramatic, 2 straight games, that USD game, double overtime again, and luckily you found the back of the net.
Yeah, I thought we played really well against USD in the first half, maybe a little unfortunate not to get a goal, and it did have a little bit of a feel that as the game wore on, are we going to get one from that standpoint. It kind of felt like USD was maybe playing for the point or for the tie as the game wore on, but proud of the way we played. I say that all the time. That's how we evaluate our team, is how did we play, not by what the scoreboard says or what the stat sheet says. But I thought we played with the right amount of focus and the right amount of intensity, and I think we balanced really our intelligence and our intensity really well that night.
Does the team get discouraged, when the shot disparity, I think it was like 16-1 after that first half, does that, concern them or rattle them that, hey, what do we need to do to actually get to the back of the net, or how do they respond to that?
I don't think discouragement is the right word. I think what happens is we played really well in the first half, and if you're the other team, you realize you've got to do some things a little bit different. And if you're the team that's had a lot of success, you kind of feel like maybe it'll just naturally keep going. And I think there's a little bit of a it was a case that USD made some adjustments and decided to be a little bit more compact defensively, and And we kind of felt like, you know, it's just a matter of time, but they tweaked things a little bit, and we probably didn't play with quite the same edge we had in the first half. And so the second half, I thought it slipped back a little bit.
NDSU on Sunday, you know, haven't had a lot of success up there in recent years. They had your number again, a 1-0 win on a good shot from them that just beat Maggie up high. Kind of break down that game a little bit again.
Yeah, I thought it wasn't our best, and I'll give NDSU a ton of credit for that. I thought they defended with a tremendous amount of energy. You know, Maggie talks about being the more mentally tough team on the field. I thought NDSU was on Sunday, and more times than not, that's the team that finds success. And it was a typical cold, windy day in Fargo, and to NDSU's credit, they found a way to score a goal to beat us. And it was a pretty evenly played game. It was a pretty defensive game. I think both teams had one shot, really, from within the penalty area. So that tells you it was played a large part in between, in the middle third of the field. And, you know, and we've got to be a little bit better to get in some better spots to score. And we've got to play with a little bit more energy.
Three games left. Talk about the two coming up this week. Start with Omaha on Friday.
Yeah, Omaha's good, and they're playing with a lot of confidence right now. I believe they're 2-0-1 in their last three games, and you know, and they're just coming off a win against USD, and so they're going to come in and play with the mindset that they need some wins to climb back into the top four. And but they're playing their best soccer that they have right now. Really, really good possession-oriented team, move the ball pretty well, dangerous from a variety of areas in the attack, and you know, they'll cause us some problems for sure. Our focus this week is really on us and getting back to defining what our best looks like.
Oral Roberts on Sunday, a team that's, I think, fourth in the standings now. You know, they're going to need some wins yet to stay in that top four and get in the tournament. Preview the Golden Eagles for us.
Right. Oral Roberts is a well-coached team. Ton of respect for that club. And more than that, they play the game a little bit differently. You know, they've got a different flair to the game. They have a lot of diversity on their team, some international players, good dribblers, can play in tight spaces. It takes a ton of focus to be able to defend a team like that. And so that will really be the challenge on Sunday.